Hello, I'm Manisha from Ananda Permaculture Farm. Welcome to this video. So today is the last day that I have these poplar trees right behind me, because tomorrow morning they are going to be all harvested. So I thought, why not take out some time and share with you with what thought we had planted these poplar trees and why they are going to be gone tomorrow. So agroforestry has been something that economists have propagated for a while, asking farmers to introduce and inculcate more trees in their farm as a source of revenue. In a permaculture farm, we grow many trees anyways, right? So we have so many trees here which are medicinal or fruiting or flowering or native trees. And most of these trees we are not going to harvest for any purpose. But agroforestry in our context are trees that we are specifically planting with a purpose to harvest them and sell them to make some money. So the only harvestable tree that we've planted here has been the poplar tree, which is right here behind me. The poplar tree is used in the plywood industry, and after about 5 years you can actually sell these off, and they go for about, let's say, around 600 to 800 rupees per quintal. It's time now for us to sell these, but I wanted to share my experience with growing poplar trees as an agroforestry tree. Let's just go back in history a little bit and discuss how poplar became a tree of choice in North India for commercial growing. Basically, somebody somewhere along the way introduced the idea to farmers that they can grow trees on the boundary of their fields, continue to grow the crops the way they do them, but also harvest these trees and sell them over a period of time. Now, you may remember traditionally there were always a few neem trees or mango trees that farmers used to put on their periphery. Now, very quickly they started replacing those trees with poplar, because you know the idea was that this can be sold, they'll make some additional income. But the challenge with the poplar tree was that its leaf litter is actually very, very thick and takes a long time to decompose. Now, when this leaf, which also tends to fly easily in the air and land on the ground, when this leaf started actually forming a layer on the fields, the farmers realized that nothing was germinating through them. This was becoming sort of an impermeable layer on top of their fields. So they quickly rejected the idea of planting poplar. And by now, because poplar had become so synonymous with trees, they actually gave up the whole idea of planting any trees altogether. So people started saying nothing grows under a tree. They meant poplar, but it ended up being nothing grows under a tree, therefore do not plant any trees. So coming back to us, what did we do? We planted poplar trees within our food forest, like the kind that you can see right behind me. And we also planted poplar trees on the peripheries of some of our small fields. Our experience has been that in the food forest, like in this place, you know, when the leaf litter drops, most of it is falling there at the back. That's not such a huge disadvantage, and it's actually just creating some leaf litter and mulch on the ground. But in the field, it's a challenge to have poplar trees on the periphery, because the leaves actually create quite a impermeable layer and we find it difficult to grow crops under it. So I would recommend that if you want to grow poplar as a tree, don't plant it on the periphery of your field. Plant it scattered within your permaculture farm so that their leaf litter is not posing a problem. So now it's time for us to actually say goodbye to these trees. It's been 5 years. They've served us well. We've been cutting their branches every year to use them to make wood chips. And we will make some money by selling them, which will be a welcome addition to our revenue stream. But will I grow these again? I don't think so. Because it has been quite a challenge for us to deal with this hard to decompose leaf. So that's really been my experience. Would I still want to do agroforestry? Probably yes. I think there are some very, very good and valuable trees that are worth growing. It might be teak, might be sandalwood, might be tun. You know, some of these woods are actually really good from a timber perspective. You know, if you want to build a house or make some furniture, you can actually get wood from your own source. Downside is that they're slow growing. But you know, you never get anything good in a hurry. So it's all right to plant things which take time. Think about the future generation. I think in the past, sometimes they used to say that whenever a baby is born, plant some teak trees. By the time the baby is 20 years old, there'll be enough money for that baby's education and you know, wedding and anything else that you want to spend on your child. So that's the philosophy I'm going to follow, and I'll be planting many more teak trees for agroforestry as opposed to poplar trees. So that's it from me. Hope you found this chat interesting, and do keep watching, share our video with others, and do subscribe to our channel. Bye-bye.